dispatched around Africa to explain the truth of the developments that occurred in the country. At the end of the panel's last visit, the head of the delegation, former president of Mali, Alpha Omar Konari, urged groups in Egypt to back the transitional roadmap. He stressed the decision surrounding Egypt's status within the Union in the responsibility of the Peace and Security Council.
So African countries, Mr. Alfi, are right now, they know quite well the image in Egypt that we are adamant to continue on the roadmap, and at the same time, they support Egypt's transitional process. Regarding other developments, the AU holds the 32nd session within the meeting of the AU Peace and Security. They put the report on Egypt. So the image is clarified to the AU, isn't it?
Yes, but not to the most of EU countries or EU officials exactly, because most of the EU officials and the European decision in many countries of Europe is following the American strategy. Is not completely independent, but following the American strategy and the American direction exactly.
Mm-hmm. How can we work on that? I mean, how can we work on further clarifying the image? We have Alpha Omar Konari here supporting the roadmap. Yeah. And this is a message to the whole world that Egypt is on the right track.
We can rely on the active characters like Alpha
like
Omar Konari.
Yes.
Mm-hmm. And also we have Moroccans, they are supporting mm-hmm. Egypt
right.
also.
Mm-hmm.
They have excellent relations inside Europe. They mm-hmm. can support and they can clarify the situation. Mm-hmm. And they are last issue by Moroccan government. We are supporting Egypt against terrorism, and
right.
they are ready. We can rely on our friends. Mm-hmm. Because we are not in a strong situation, especially for our Ministry of Foreign Affairs. The minister is doing a great effort. The minister, as the Egyptian Foreign Minister, is doing a really great effort.
Nabil Fahmy.
Yes, but really he need too much support.
Mm-hmm.
Also from other ambassadors and the
most of our consulates and ambassadors in Africa, yes, they are working hard on crystallizing Egypt's personality, where we are today. And Mr. Alfi, you're talking about building an economic city. That's a brilliant idea.
Yeah.
I mean, it can bring about even new calibers of investors. We do have more than one a friend supporting Egypt from Gulf countries, also from Saudi Arabia, the United Arab Emirates. And how can they contribute to such a project, and how far do you think is it going to be feasible?
We can create this plan within 6 months. Mm-hmm. We can do it within 6 months, create a plan.
Mm-hmm.
And for example, I'm telling all via Nile TV, we can go to the north coast to create this economic capital city.
Why do you think is the north coast a strategic location?
Because it's very near from North Africa,
mm-hmm.
and also very near from south of Europe, and that we can.
So you think that it is a focal point where both can meet.
Yes, and after that we can move to. To the east of Egypt. To south of Egypt. To also to construct a new cities also
mm-hmm.
in this area as a tourist cities. This area near to Halaib and Shalatin is very attractive.
Mm-hmm.
More rather than Sharm el-Sheikh and Hurghada. After that, we can move.
The area near Halaib and Shalatin, I want just to stop here concerning this area and know more from you concerning the potential of this area. How can it contribute to an economic boom?
Yes, this area is very near to the Sudan borders. And this it's a strategic construction, because what I'm expecting in the next months from the movement, the extreme movements, it will try to attack the Egyptian borders via Sudan and via Libya. So we have to start our work in these areas, in these two areas especially.
God bless our army.
Yeah.
Well, the decision to the presidential elections first accelerate and contribute to crystallizing Egypt's personality in dealing with the foreign countries. Back to the presidential elections and that important milestone, what are we expecting while we are preparing for the presidential elections? How will the situation further develop your reading into this important milestone?
Regarding presidential elections, the whole world will watch.
Right, definitely.
Yeah, the
whole it is going to be the main headline.
Yeah, the whole world is still, they are waiting who's the next president for Egypt.
Right.
Because they rely on the cooperation with the next leader for Egypt. Not all of them against, even if they will try to blame if we will change some amendments in roadmap, if they will try to blame us sometimes, but all of them actually, they understand well in business, so they do care about them business in this area, so they do care also about the person who will lead Egypt in the next stage. We have to work and to put pressure at this point exactly to do care about business with them.
How will the choice of Egypt's new leader change the status quo?
The new leader of Egypt will carry
a huge responsibility. Definitely, a historic one at the same time because of the timing.
Yeah, it's I trust the one who's coming. I don't like to say I know him from now, but the next leader of Egypt can deal with them because he will go directly after he will be elected. They will wait which plans he will use. He will go to cooperation with them, or he will go to be against them. But what I understand that the next leader will cooperate with the whole world, will not be against anyone, is not working against Egypt.
Definitely, out of the matter of fact that Egypt's national interests come first, definitely, and the criteria of the man who should lead the country now to a safe haven, that is definitely a very important question. Meantime, a leader with a vision, a leader who is inspirational, a leader who is strong enough to control the situation. How can this create change, in your opinion? For the better, definitely.
Yeah. The whole world is respecting the strong...
The Egyptian will.
Yeah.
And they saw how Egyptians are determined to draw themselves their future. They saw how Egyptians, how the power of the people now has changed the whole equation.
Yes, but let me talk about the people outside or leaders outside. They are respecting the strong leaders. Even if his country in a weak situation, they respect the strong leader with vision. And each one is, all countries will try to cooperate with him because he has a vision, he's serving the people outside, respecting the strong leader and respecting the one who's serving his country and respect his people. That is what I'm expecting from the next leader to Egypt. But also, Egyptians must carry responsibilities.
Right.
Must work hard.
From for making their country better.
At least we need to achieve a progress to our country, to create a real Egypt, the modern Egypt. We need to work from 7 to 10 years non-stop for the whole Egyptians. And I believe that most of the Egyptians will get work inside Egypt, not outside Egypt, in the next stage. People must keep hope, not be pessimistic from a little problems with terrorists.
Definitely.
The terrorists will not stop our plans.
But they have no place in New Egypt at the same time.
There is no place for them everywhere, and all countries protecting them and supporting them will pay a price one day very, very soon. We know them, of course.
Definitely. Well, a very important question also is the files, the pressing files. Right after the president, new president of Egypt is going to take office. You mentioned education as a core. Yes,
yeah.
It should come, I guess, on top of the list. Healthcare services. What more?
Industrial sector.
Mm-hmm.
And training programs.
Yes. You mean manpower?
Yeah.
Training,
yes.
The
training,
people.
Training. Yeah. For manpower, for the Egyptian manpower.
Yes.
We must prepare them according to our new projects, to our needs. We don't need, like before, to have a million.
Prepare them for the labor market.
Yes. We don't need to have a million of graduates with no experience. So we spend billions to teach them how to write, how to get certificate. But we didn't teach them. We are wasting time. We didn't teach them how to work, how to be specialist in this field or that field. That is the main challenge for us if we would like to achieve a progress in all sectors.
Right, achieving progress in all sectors. Yes, definitely the sky is the limit, and Egypt is embarking on a historic moment in the history of the country, the history of the nation. Nomination of a new president, definitely it is going to change the whole face of the country. Mr. Mohammed Al-Alfi, who is international political and economic analyst for tonight, thank you very much for coming to Nile TV and sharing with us your opinions and thoughts, which are always appreciated. Thank you so much.
My pleasure. Thank you very much for Nile TV.
Thank you. And thank you, dear viewers, for joining us. That was the Daily Debate for tonight. I'm Taghreed Hussain, thanking you all for joining us.